I have just one thing to say to you. Vocaloid. Let's get started. So this figure that I'm showing you is Ea, Ariana the Planet's version 1.5. It's called 1.5 because the first version didn't turn out so well, and then shortly after they released this one. So this figure was manufactured by Aquamarine. It is a 1/8 scale and it was released twice, once in 2015 and once in 2019. The original price for this reached about 9,500 yen. And no surprise, the aftermarket really went up. According to my research, the only difference between the versions 1.5 and the version 1 is number 1, change of skin texture, number 2, the gradient of the eyes, and number 3, a little bit of the hair, the positioning and the coloring as well. Honestly, I haven't seen version 1 in person, but there's actually a blog online that I will link down below comparing version 1 to version 1.5. So Ea is a Japanese Vocaloid developed and distributed by the First Place Company Limited and was released in January 2012 for the Vocaloid 3 engine. Her voice is provided by the Japanese female singer-songwriter Lia. So I guess it's pretty obvious why her name is Ea. Her design was illustrated by Aka Akasaka, who also illustrated Kaguya-sama, Love is War, and Oshinoko. While her design direction was by Maxilla Inc. Although there is no official age for Ea, a lot of people say that she is 15 because her voice provider Lia actually debuted in America at 15 years old. So of course I got into Vocaloid because of none other than Miku herself, who is currently the most popular Vocaloid, dare I say one of the most popular characters in Japanese culture. And then later on, of course, I got to meet Mekurin Luka, Kagamine Rin and Len, Kaito, Meiko, and so much more. But for some reason, I have always liked Ea the most. I guess it's probably the design, and probably because of her name. And as much as I like Miku and the hype around her and the other 5 popular Vocaloids, I would love to see Ea take on the spotlight. I'm actually quite surprised that she doesn't even have an Android yet. I mean, Gakupo has one. So how come Ea doesn't? So I'm really hoping sometime in the future to see more scales of her, bigger scales of her, and of course an Android. I also wouldn't mind a B-style of her. Trust me, if she has a B-style, that is instant pre-order for me. So my final thoughts on this figure. Of course, this figure was one of the first, I think, that was released by Aquamarine, so I understand the quality control. But I have to say that I really like her. I may be biased, but like I said, I don't really care much for the little painting errors. Because I'm going to be displaying her and I'm not going to be looking at her close up 24/7. As for her base, well, I don't actually mind. Surprisingly, I don't even mind the pegs. Actually, I already have a plan on how to display her, and I'm planning to make a video of it soon because I'm going to be displaying all my figures in the same way, so I hope you look forward to that. So, would I say that she is worth it for the cost that she's going for? Personally, yes. If, of course, the box and the figure is still intact and not much damage to it. But hey, to each their own. So I hope you guys enjoyed this short unboxing video of Ea. And tell me down below, which among the other Vocaloid characters do you want to see as a figure or as an Android? I'm looking forward to hearing from you. So until next time, bye!